Welcome to Dreamweaver Crocheting with Love. In today's tutorial, I am going to teach you one of our design stitches. In this design stitch, we have combined a V stitch along with the double crochet clusters. Double crochet clusters is nothing but working three double crochets together all into the single stitch. It's a very simple yet a pretty stitch. So let's see how the stitch is worked out. For this, initially in the first round, we'll be working V stitches, that is one double crochet separated by one chain and another double crochet. So in this way, we'll be working the V stitch for the first row of the design stitch, and in the second row, we'll be working three double crochets inside this chain one spaces. And these two rows will be repeated as many times as you want for your project work. For this, I've taken a 4mm crochet hook. And the stitch is a multiple of 3 plus 4 stitches. So, for the first row, I have worked a simple double crochet row consisting of 22 double crochets. So, now we will be starting with the first row of our design stitch. For that, I need to chain 1 and turn my work and work a double crochet into the first stitch. Now we need to skip next two stitches and work a V stitch into the third stitch, that is a double crochet followed by chain 1 and again one more double crochet into the same space. Now skip two stitches and again work a V stitch. So you have to repeat this, that is working a V and then skipping two stitches, and into the third stitch again you will be working a V. So just continue like this till you are left with the last 3 stitches. So here I have done the first row of our design stitch. So now I am left with last 3 stitches. So I will be skipping the next 2 stitches and working a double crochet into the last stitch. So this finishes our row 1. Now for the second row, again chain 1 and turn your work and work a double crochet into the first stitch. Now here you can see the V stitches are having a chain 1 space between them. So we will be working clusters of double crochets, that is working 3 double crochets inside the chain 1 space. So into the first chain 1 space I am working 3 double crochets. Now skip the remaining double crochets of the V stitches and work 3 double crochets into the chain 1 space of V stitch. Again jump to the next chain 1 space and work 3 double crochets inside the chain 1 space. So just continue working like this. So here I have worked 3 double crochets into the last chain 1 space, and now we need to work 1 double crochet on top of the last stitch. So this finishes our second row. Now for the third row, again chain 1 and turn your work and work 1 double crochet on top of the first stitch. Now we need to skip the next stitch and work 1 V stitch into the middle double crochet of the 3 double crochet that we had worked in the chain 1 space of the previous row. So going to the middle stitch, again I will be working a V stitch, that is double crochet followed by chain 1 and again one more double crochet into the same stitch. Now again we will be skipping the next 2 stitches and working 1 V stitch into the middle stitch of the double crochet cluster. So you have to just repeat like this, working a V stitch into the middle stitch of the 3 double crochets that we had worked in the previous row. So here I have worked the last V stitch of this round, and again in order to complete this row, we'll be working one double crochet onto the last stitch. So this finishes our third row. Now from here onwards, we have to just repeat the row 2 and 3 as many number of times as we want, depending upon the project work for which we are using the stitch. Now, since these stitches have lots of gaps, so it's very comfortable to wear during summer times. So you can work a baby cardigan or a baby frock, especially the skirt part of the baby frock, using these stitches. So I hope this tutorial was really very useful for you. In case of any queries, please let me know through comments. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.